congratulations on your Critics' Choice nomination. I'm so thrilled about that.
Thanks, dude. That's very cool. It's mad. It's really wild.
Well, well deserved. And I have to say, I was really excited to speak with you today because my husband actually recently gave me an anniversary gift. It was our 5 year for Wood. And he made me this, which I hope shows up. Oh gosh, it's blurry. Wait, there we go.
We pull it back to your face.
Oh no. Okay.
Oh my God.
Okay,
oh
there we go.
Remember, it's just poop. Let it flow.
He got it personally engraved. See, so it's your photo.
Oh, and that's so amazing. Remember, it's just pooper. Let it flow.
Yeah. Hi, just like in the sewer.
Bingo, El Ringo. What looks like happened is that this is being censored because it's really sensitive material. And it's like really like, whatever you got is very naughty.
Yeah, that's what it feels like. Yeah. That. You're right. It's like I'm doing things not appropriate, but that's not. I thought it would show a lot more. I thought if I'd hide my face. Okay.
Pooper is being censored. Zoom is censoring pooper.
Yeah, it's actually for our bathroom, so I can see it and remember. But he
just
got
to remind you to eat dates and prunes.
He got it for me because I was it's our favorite quote from the season. And so we quote it all the time, but just, I've been stressed at work and he's like, it's a reminder to always remember. So
he's a very
always.
Sweet man. Oh, I'm glad. And I'm looking down on you and in all the activities that happen in the bathroom. That's just for disclaimer, I don't have any hidden cameras or anything. That's
but I was wondering, when has that motto been most useful in your life?
I guess it's for good and bad. Mm-hmm. I suppose. I think that sometimes if you look at when somebody is, they're making decisions that sort of you maybe wouldn't have done or that impact your life in some way, shape or form, whether it's someone pushing in the front of a queue or whether it's a loved one sort of making a weird decision, you can only do so much. You can only you can control what you can control. Mm-hmm. I guess it's sort of Jamie Tartt's serenity prayer. But also I think it's when good things are happening as well. It's sort of, you know, it's in the same way that don't take the bad things personally, try not to take the good things too personally either, because it's all ups and downs. And if you cling on too much to something being great, then, you know, inevitably when those things change, then I think that one might be disappointed. So I think it's just like, it's easy come, easy go kind of thing.
Yeah. Well, your Jamie Tartt's character arc is easily one of the best character arcs I've ever seen on television. And I've really enjoyed seeing where he started from season one to where he ended in season three. And I was just wondering what's been your favorite part of his development throughout the series?
I think seeing the bits where we understand why he is the way he is. And I think with his parents, that's been good seeing that stuff. I think that's been really nice. The scene that I have with Leanne Best, who plays James' mum, was such a great thing to do, because in a weird way, I learned so much about Jamie and also my choices with Jamie, because when I met Leanne, mm-hmm. she was so good at serving what that relationship was, and she brought so much to it, such kindness and softness and power to it, that I learned so much from that. So things like that, that's where you get to see how far Jamie's come, I suppose, because we understand who he was, but now it's at this sort of full circle that we see when he goes back home and sees his mum. You know, we've seen what he's like with his dad or what his dad's like with him, and therefore, you know, that explains a little of his character. But there'll always be really wonderful, you know, times that I had filming stuff like the fight that he has with his dad or any mm-hmm. any scene ever with Brett Goldstein, and so it's probably, you know, in that sort of upper echelon of career highlights, but
yeah. That episode with Jamie's mom was really nice to see too. Gave us another perspective of his life that I really enjoyed. But I am a big fan of watching Jamie and Roy's friendship. Like that has been, you guys could seriously have a spinoff and I would very much enjoy that. I'm wondering what was your favorite scene you've done with Brett Goldstein throughout the series?
Favorite is, I mean, I think the one, well, yeah, so many. I suppose the one where we're doing the Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid ode to with the bikes, I think was a pretty special moment. Doing that with him was great. The scene, I actually think one of the first scenes that we did, which was us at the gala in episode 4 in season 1. I loved that, and I knew Brett. I'd played, weirdly, 10 years before playing Jamie Tartt, I had played effectively Brett in a play, because he had written it. That's when I first met him. This random writer turned up to watch the play he'd written, put on by 3 idiots from a different town, so I had known about Brett for a long time. You know, was a big fan of his work, and then so being able to do that where there was like a really lovely sort of respect between the two of them was really nice.
Wow, I didn't know that. It's too bad we can't see that play, if that's somewhere floating around.
Hell no, it is lost. I mean, the play is very good, but
yeah,
it was a, you know, we were young, dumb, and desperate to put on production. So
well, I'm curious, you know, the show I feel like has meant so much to so many people, but what is it that you hope audiences have taken away from the series?
That they all now are obsessed with football. I think, I hope that's probably that's the pinnacle of what I hope. I don't know. I mean, look, I think that it would be too overreaching of me to sort of say I hope that people choose kindness over judgment or whatever. I don't think that's the world's too complicated to sort of to hope that something is as clean as that comes out of it. But I just think that I think that it's probably just little by little those little bits sort of peek into your life. And you know, I think as sort of cliched and pathetic as it is, I have thought to myself in times when I felt nervous or conceited to sort of just sort of parrot to myself, be curious, not judgmental. I think that it is sometimes pretty useful, and it's amazing what happens when you do think that. As sort of embarrassingly on brand as that may seem, it's actually a pretty great little. It has real life uses.
I love you guys so very much.
On three, 1, 2, 3.
I love you guys so very much. Richard!
Great job!
Oh! Rock Kent just said great job! Oh.